Good morning, Seneca Valley. Today is Thursday, May 9th, and you're watching Family Week on The Seneca Says. I'm Jack Reynolds, alongside my sister.
I'm Ella Reynolds.
And let's get to today's announcements.
Okay. The last day for after-school tutoring is Thursday, May 16th. And speaking of which, today is also the last day to buy chocolate and or bear to send to a senior on their last day. Hershey Kisses with a personalized note are for $1, and a bear, including the chocolate note, is for $5. They are being sold outside the cafeteria by the junior class during all lunches.
On Tuesday, the Ryan Gloyer Middle School Band performed their spring concert in the IHS. The 7th and 8th grade groups played a variety of songs, such as Flight of the Eagle, Lullaby in the Mirror, and a Danny Elfman melody. SVTV was there for the concert and will be airing it several times over the next few weeks, so tune in and look for several other great concerts on the channel. In other news, cheer and dance tryouts are coming soon. Those currently in grades 8 through 11 are eligible. There is a mandatory athlete meeting on Thursday, May 9th in the IHS cafeteria at 3 p.m. Contact Coach Wise if you have any questions. And now for today's lunch.
And then the little blurb underneath your name said Seneca Valley. Now, I don't know about you, but I think you should certainly stick around for that pasta bar.
I think I will be.
Okay. Pom-pom practice for tryouts will be held on Tuesday, May 28th through Thursday, May 30th from 4:30 to 6:30 in the middle school gym. The actual tryout for the pom-pom squad will take place on Saturday morning, June 1st, beginning at 8 a.m. Girls who plan on trying out need to visit the svband.net to print out an information packet. And speaking of which, let's look at a video that is very bizarre sense of fashion back then. Let's take a look.
Good morning, Seneca Valley. I'm Nicholas Schuster, and I'm here to give you your random fact of the day. So let's talk fashion and how fashion can be more intense than the Devil Wears Prada.
That I can't even talk about.
All right, everyone, gird your loins.
In 1797, British tailor John Hetherington invented the first top hat and was so happy with it that he decided to wear the hat in public. What happened next was beyond ridiculous. Hetherington's hat caused women to faint, dogs to yelp, children to cry, and a riot to take place.
I can't believe we're even talking about this. This is madness.
Hetherington was charged for breaching the peace and inciting a riot and was required to pay £500 to the state. So be careful about the new things you wear, guys. And also, I'm wearing this cowboy hat today in honor of him. Let's get back to the announcement.
Thanks for that, Nick. And you know, people may have been hating on the top hat, but when Abe Lincoln rocked it, he brought it in.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Seneca. I hope you enjoyed one of our days during Family Week. Thank you to my brother, Jack Reynolds.
Thank you for having
me. I hope to see you tomorrow.
We can go slow, make it go faster now.